Welcome to March's Camper Corner. This month's theme is spring, and I am going to be teaching you four crafts. The first craft is going to be a one-line drawing. The second craft is going to be tissue paper flowers. The third craft is going to be a bird feeder, and the final craft is going to be a recycled bird house. But before we get crafting, I thought it'd be fun to show you a few hand shadow puppets. Since spring leads to longer days, that means there's less time that you can do shadow hand puppets. So here are three ones that you can use. The first one is the butterfly. You take one hand and you put it over the other and make sure that thumbs don't go like this. Put your hands together. The second one is a swan. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna make a little, like you're pinching salt, but like this, and you're gonna kind of move one of the fingers so it has a pointed end, and then you're gonna use your other hand to go like this. There's your swan. And the final shadow puppet is going to be the bunny, and what you need to do is you're gonna take your hand and you're gonna make an okay sign, then you're gonna press your thumb up so that your finger goes like this. Okay? And then you're gonna take your pinky and you're gonna put it on your thumb. And this is gonna make the head of the bunny. Then you're gonna make a peace sign. And then you're gonna curl it underneath, like so. Do you see the bunny? And all of them can be shown right up here. For the one line drawing, you're going to need a piece of paper and a pen. You can also have some watercolors and some watercolor paper. Totally optional, but if you like working with watercolors, it can be a fun little addition to the craft.
So the first thing that you are going to do is figure out the logistics of your one line drawing and draw out your design lightly with a pencil. Then you are going to take your pen and outline everything. If you want, you can add a splash of color using watercolors. With the squirrel, I thought it would be fun to color in all the lines and shapes inside. Then with the chick, I decided to do a more realistic approach. When I think of spring, I think of little tiny chicks. If you've ever visited a farm during this time of year, you know there are usually crates upon crates of these cute little yellow puffballs. Finally, I decided to do a really simple design for the baby lion. I made the baby lion line drawing because I think baby lions are adorable.
For the tissue paper flowers, you are going to need tissue paper, string, and scissors.
To begin, you're going to get many layers of tissue paper and cut them into rectangles that are all the same size. Once stacked, fold all of them together using an accordion fold. Then take a piece of string and go around the middle and make a tight knot. Snip, snip. Cut the ends of your paper. This next step requires patience. Slowly pull the different layers apart and scrunch everything into the middle of the structure. And you're done!
For the bird feeder, you're going to need peanut butter or an alternative one if you're allergic, seeds and nuts, a pine cone, and string.
Start by wrapping your string around the tip or base of your pine cone and securing it with a knot. Cover every inch of your pine cone with peanut butter or an alternative. Then roll your pine cone into some seeds and nuts. Also, if you don't have pine cones in your area, you can use a stick, a leaf, or even a toilet paper tube. Hang it on a tree branch nearby and wait to see those birds.
The birds love it! And finally, for the birdhouse, you are going to need a juice carton or anything that you can find in a recycling bin that you think would work. You can really get creative with this one. Paint, scissors, a hot glue gun and glue, string, a stick, and a hole puncher, but you don't really need it. You can use your scissors if you want. Okay, let's get started.
The first thing that you are going to do is cut a circle into your juice container. Then you are going to use your hole punch and make a small hole below the circle. Make four slots. Hot glue the end of your stick and punch it through the hole and stick the stick onto the inside of the container. Paint! You can add a window or some sticks for your roof. Finally, make a hole at the top, thread a piece of string through, and hang it on a branch nearby.
I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next month. Bye!